Hey guys, Naisha here, you know, Just an Average Girl, and I'm back with another episode of Just an Average Craft Corner. I'm browsing on Amazon looking for challenging puzzles like the one that I did with the peacock. I stumbled across what I feel is going to be a masterpiece of a puzzle. It is a magic cello. Yes, people, this is actually a puzzle that you actually get to put together, and it plays music. So it's a wooden puzzle that deals with gears. And of course, you're gonna have to be very delicate with this thing. But I mean, it's just gorgeous. And I told myself, you know what? I have to figure this out. I wanna see for myself just how, you know, awesome and intricate this puzzle is. So today we are gonna put it together. And again, like I said, I believe this, for those who love puzzles, this would be a great Christmas gift because, I mean, if someone were to give this to me, I would be awed and all that stuff because I love putting things together. And especially something as challenging looking as this, I would, you know, I would have fun with this and I would take my time with it. But yeah, like I said, it's a mechanical music box by Rokr. And yeah, it's a nocturne in E flat. Okay, that's the music that it's probably going to be playing. So I look forward to putting this together. So let's get to it. All right, so when you open this up, this is what you will get. You will get everything. Like I said, it is a puzzle in itself. All the pieces. It is wooden. And I mean, you're actually going to be putting together a cello with all of these parts. So this looks amazing. Of course, here is the music box itself, along with tools that we're gonna be using to put all this together. And thankfully, you know, everything that we need, including the instructions. So it looks a lot, but like I said, I think this is gonna come out fun. What I like is that they also have sandpaper, so I guess if any of the edges or any of the sides just need a little trimming or need a little sanding down, you can do so. Look at these gears. How adorable is this? Okay. We're getting there, people. We're getting there. Now, in case you guys didn't realize, there is an arrow here and an arrow on this gear. Make sure that those two are, you know, pretty much meeting each other. So that means that you're doing it right. The circles with circles. All right. So this part, I have to be very careful because these parts right here are very fragile. So, and just to let you know, it says, a young man once asked Casalas, a violinist, how can I become an excellent violinist? Casalas' answer is like this. First, be an excellent musician, then try your best to be an excellent musician, and then keep practicing, and you will become a great violinist. So, and as you can see, Vintage Cello by Rokr. So, I just have to put them together and carefully put them in the center. All right, so again, I think I'm in the fragile zone because as you can see, I am dealing with another page where it says, happiness shouts descend on thou. So yes, all right. But once again, very fragile. So I have to be very careful. Oh, absolutely. We'll be right back. This is definitely a very hard and delicate part. I implore that you be very, very, very careful, because here is where the gears have to connect in here. And you are gently pushing all of this in. Without breaking anything. The cat is in. That part of the cello is in. Okay, yep. The gears are moving as they should. Okay. So like I said, you have to be very patient with this because this is wood. But it's in. People, it is in. So now to do the final part. Now, before I completely finish and all that stuff, they want you to test it out to make sure that the box works. And that part is very, very important because I actually literally took the time to dismantle the entire thing to see what was going on. And turns out it was probably this gear. And also on top of that, I did not add wax to it. There was an indicator that I ignored because I figured, it'll go through. No. It needs lubrication. It needs wax. So it is very important that where it indicates to wax the wheels, wax the these little plastic things right there. And it should definitely work. So here we go before I finish this. Hold on. Alright, so I'm seeing some jumps there, but probably has something to do with this thing right there. But the fact that it works, I'm just going to let it slide because, like I said, it took some time for me to get in there and figure out what was going on. So let's go ahead and finish this little masterpiece, and I will give my final thoughts on it.
Beautiful. Now that we're done, here are my thoughts. The tools were a big help in this project, and I love the fact that you had to build it. The items needed to build this could have been better, as one bag held all the screws, when it would have been easier to put them in individual packets like some were. I especially love the extra parts, because there were times I accidentally broke pieces, but I had spares to fall back on. Overall, I feel this is a great Christmas gift for anyone who loves crafts and classical music. I don't know if you've seen it, but I'm building a 3-foot Optimus Prime from the classic 80s cartoon. You can find the playlist here. If not, check out the time I put together the Lego Thanos gauntlet and vanished.